Episode number 155. Above all things be always on your guard. The cardinal has a tenacious memory, and a long arm. You may depend upon it, he will repay you by some Milton. But of what sort? Hey! How can I tell? Has he not all the tricks of a demon at his command? The least that can be expected is that you will be arrested. What? Will they dare to arrest a man in his majesty's service? Pardieu! They did not scruple much in the case of Athos. At all events, young man, rely upon one who has been 30 years at court. Do not lull yourself in security, or you will be lost. But, on the contrary, and it is I who say it, see enemies in all directions. If anyone seeks a quarrel with you, shun it, were it with a child of 10 years old. If you are attacked by day or by night, fight, but retreat, without shame. If you cross a bridge, fill every plank of it with your foot, lest one should give way beneath you. If you pass before a house which is being built, look up, for fear a stone should fall upon your head. If you stay out late, be always followed by your lackey, and let your lackey be armed, if, by the by, you can be sure of your lackey. Mistrust everybody, your friend, your brother, your mistress above all. D'Artagnan blushed. My mistress above all, repeated he, mechanically. And why rather than another? Because a mistress is one of the cardinal's favorite means, is not one that is more expeditious. A woman will sell you for 10 pistoles, witness Delilah. You are acquainted with the scriptures. D'Artagnan thought of the appointment MME. Bonacieux had made with him for that very evening, but we are bound to say, to the credit of Iro, that the bad opinion entertained by him the trivial of women in general, did not inspire him with the least suspicion of his pretty hostess. But, à propos, resumed him the trivial, what has become of your 3 companions? I was about to ask you if you had heard any news of them. None, monsieur. Well, I left them on my road, Porthos at Chantilly, with a duel on his hands, Aramis at Crèvecoeur, with a ball in his shoulder, and Athos at Amiens, detained by an accusation of coining. See there, now, said M. de Tréville, and how the devil did you escape? By a miracle, monsieur, I must acknowledge, with a sword thrust in my breast, and by nailing the Comte de Wardes on the byroad to Calais, like a butterfly on a tapestry. There again. The words, one of the cardinal's men, a cousin of Rochefort. Stop, my friend, I have an idea. Speak, monsieur. In your place, I would do one thing. What? While his eminence was seeking for me in Paris, I would take, without sound of drum or trumpet, the road to Picardy, and would go, and make some inquiries concerning my 3 companions. What the devil? They merit richly that piece of attention on your part.